So sometimes stuff happens, and this woman, the law was against her. She had no legal recourse. The law, the year of Jubilee, and everything is against you. That's mine. I just left it. No, somebody moved in on me. And God keeps having me telling the king a story about what God had done in the past. You know what? That's the woman. And that's your son. But what do you want, woman? She's crying and boo-hooing, making her complaint known. And somebody had intervened. I mean, did he intervene or did he just tell what had been going on in her life? So, I don't know.
Jehazi was there just at that time to let the king know that the hand of God was on that woman.
Yeah. So, just happened.
Happened to be there.
I can't give you the 1, 2, 3s on what to do to be blessed by God. All I can tell you is that doing the right and living right, and the stuff, life's upside down for you, but even in the hard times, God can come to you. Like he does come to you, and he straightens stuff out. You know?
Yeah, well, she, see, years earlier, she had planted some seeds.
Yeah.
And the seed she planted was, you know, building this little room.
And feeding the prophet when
he came back, and, you know, housing him and doing all that. Yeah, she planted some seeds. Yeah. So there, she was reaping a harvest.
She reaped a whole lot more, but he could have paid her for rent for that.
It also has something to do with the king, didn't it? About him believing in God.
Yeah, he's kind of.
Both of them kings.
Yeah. Tell me something God has done. He had no idea God was getting ready to use him to make a decision. That's that moment. My lord, O king, this is the woman. This is her son. Verse 6, when the king asked the woman, she told him. The king appointed to her a certain officer. So he took somebody out of his courtroom and said, look, pay attention to her. Restore all that was hers. And then, what? The stuff she ain't even worked for. Give it to her. Everything that that land produced, give it back to her. That's 7 years of the stuff, man. So you just don't know how the Lord's going to come back around for you to make it right. But that's all God did was show her favor. And he showed her favor outside the law. Went by the letter of the law, it was outside the law. But
Well, the fact that the land had troops in a famine was an act of God in the first place.
Her standing by the law was pretty slim, but by the grace and knowing God and having a relationship and dealing with the person of God and all that kind of background, she had better standing than what she realized. The law was cut and dry. Moses says, man, Charles ain't nobody. You know, if you've gone for 7 years, it definitely ain't yours. But she's crying and saying, that's my little brother. And the king says, you know, give her the land and go and make sure whatever that man produced the last 7 years that she could get to.
Wow. Yeah. Well, she had a lot of faith because in verse 3, it says she went
to death by going
to
something
that
had to be put
forth. There's so many people, I read stories all the time about innocent project, folks, guys in jail, you know. Mm-hmm. I didn't do that, Bob. I didn't do that killing, didn't do that, right? But they sit there in those jail cells for so many years, knowing that they were there they in the right. How's this going to get straight down? I just think it took O.J. Simpson. I don't want to say to kill a woman. We have a dream team of attorneys who dealt with me. One of them sold out on forensic DNA testing. He just sold out. Now, not only the OJ trial, but he took that and made a project out of it for everybody else. And he says, I know that some people are sitting down in jail where they shouldn't be, But I'm gonna take my project and go prove their innocence. Here's some people even this woman.
That's true.
Get out, because that fool OJ, his tens of millions went to these attorneys. That attorney took his payday and turned it around for good. And helping people.
Barry Shaw.
Barry Shaw. Yeah. Barry Shaw. I said he was the poorest one dressed. Suits didn't fit. Everybody else was.
His hair kind of shaky.
Yes. But he was sold out on forensic testing. Yeah. I mean, who would have thought that doctor took that mess that OJ was in, and that guy take his payday and start a project for the good? And you get people. I'm telling you, man, if the cops put you down, you put without something that's up.
Yep.
So I cannot work here in hard times. I can't tell you the 1, 2, 3, give you the next month. I just know that
he would have.
You can't figure it out. You can't plan it. This man, but you gotta be right with God.
That's right. That's the
question. So that's the lesson. I don't know what time it is.
Wow!
You don't get no comment,
donuts. No comment, donuts. I have never moved that fast.
Well, let's go to page 41 and deal with our above the questions. Okay. This passage teaches us there are three things there. It teaches us. If you want to deal with that, we can expand the text.
Okay, throw out the first question. Is that what you're saying?
No. At the top it says, this passage teaches us several important lessons. One is that godly people are not exempt from the hardships that befall the wicked society in which they live. We've already discussed that. Really? Another lesson is that seemingly unrelated events are connected in God's plan. God used the widow's return to Israel to bring about an unforeseen and marvelous result. And the third one is still another lesson, is that God has ways of bringing justice even through unjust rulers. God reigns over rulers, and he overrules them for his own glory. Yeah. When I read the lesson, I thought that was good.
So can we really say that you're saved? You got a down economy, you played a role in that economy turning bad, on that family, that layoff. Because, you say it, bad things does happen to good people.
Good things, yeah.
You say, well, it's been living right for the Lord, and doing all the, the components and the dynamics of living right, but you get a pink slip. Why do you do it? Why me, Lord? Why me? Yeah. Like I said, it's still the lesson. Anybody ever going through some hard stuff? I just turned off. It's supposed to be like that, isn't it, for saved folks?
Yeah. 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 If they live godly, shall suffer.
Yes,
say when you fall into the valley of praise, call it joy. Yeah.
Let's take one to the movie now.
Oh, that was terrible.
You know, some folks in
there. Probably. Probably.
Got shot? Hurt? But the bullet's supposed to be, they have this what's called survivor's remorse, survivor's guilty.
Right.
Because you made it out. Man, I stepped on a guy, he was bleeding to death. I got out of it. So, why did that bullet go that way? Didn't hit me. Driving down the highway, see a wreck. That could have been me.
Why? Well, the girlfriend says about it because the guy jumped in front of them and they died.
Yeah, I don't know. That was horrible. They said his house was full of
explosives. Well, I mean, you shouldn't have been in the movie.
If you saved, you shouldn't have been in the movie.
been getting up to the church.
It's tragic. I think people that just don't understand haven't really read the word at all. They always want to think that, well, you get what you reap what you sow. And they just get a little enough of the word that they think they know what's going on. You reap what you sow, you must have done something bad or wrong to get in that situation, but it's not necessarily so.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
You got to be aware of the copycat.
Yeah.
Say,
hey,
Brother Sonny.
Yeah. Be aware of the copycat.
Yeah.
The bad thing is that this is not the last time for that to happen. Don't go out, don't get interchanged.
Church, church,
in your house.
Hospital.
Well, in Virginia Tech, he was in college. That's what you told the kids they supposed to be.
Remember that bridge on, I think it was 40 going east a little while back.
Yeah, when that's
yeah, 40 going east, that bridge collapsed or something like that.
Yeah.
It's on that bridge at that time. The bridge is going down and you own it. Guess what? You're going to save your unsaved. Whoa, what about this?
Yeah. Because during that time, Derek had a busload of kids taking them to Georgia for camp. Uh-huh. They had just passed over about 30 minutes early.
Whoa.
Whoa. Mm-hmm.
And Grace got that. Grace.
Grace.
I can say that was some of the...